Hello world. I'm Imagination. In this video, I'm going to talk about how Saudi Arabia is building a zero-carbon city in a 100-mile straight line. Saudi Arabia has unveiled its newest zero-carbon city project, called The Line. As its eyebrow-raising name suggests, the unusual metropolis will be built in a straight line more than 100 miles in length. The unconventional city will feature zero cars, zero streets, and zero carbon emissions, according to a statement by Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, and will be able to house 1 million inhabitants from around the world. The proposed city will be the first development at NEOM, a $500 billion green energy business zone in northwestern Saudi Arabia, that was created with the aim to end Saudi Arabia's economic reliance on oil exports, according to Reuters. Saudi Arabia has plenty of futuristic ideas for the site as a whole, including an artificial moon, artificial rain, robot maids, as the Wall Street Journal reported in 2019, not to mention plans for human gene editing clinics. Everything in the line will be within a 5-minute walk of home, Bin Salman says. It's still unclear how that's an option in a 100-mile-long city, but Bin Salman did note that getting from one end to the other would take just 20 minutes. That's thanks to the spine, a high-tech mode of transport that connects individual city modules. This subsurface spine layer takes care of ultra-high-speed transit and AI-enabled transport, according to the official documentation. Throughout history, cities were built to protect their citizens, Bin Salman said. After the Industrial Revolution, cities prioritized machines, cars, and factories over people. Bin Salman also argued that in the world's most advanced cities, people spend years of their lives commuting, noting that by 2050 that trend will only double. And with those harrowing commutes, more people will die from pollution. Having everything within 5 minutes away will also limit deadly traffic accidents, the prince said. Construction is set to begin in early 2021, and is expected to contribute $48 billion to the local economy, as well as 38,000 jobs. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.